Welcome to Adventures with a Very Small Lathe. This is a quick update about restoring the second larger cabinet that was already fitted to my new workshop. The inside of most of the cabinet was lined with screws, which were probably used to hold tools or equipment. Whatever they were for, I need to remove them. A hand screwdriver was going to take forever, so I gave up on that after a handful of screws. Most of the screws were in a removable shelves, and the more crooked ones gave me a lot of trouble. The bottoms of the cupboards were covered in debris from removing the screws and from when they were in use. Before anything else, I gave the whole inside a wipe down with water to clear the worst. Off camera, I removed all the doors and removed the door running strips seen here at the bottom. I then used exactly the same technique as I described in my previous video, but didn't bother to record it as I have already shown it in some detail. The process is basically stripping down the finish with methylated spirits, rubbing away the debris with wire wool, rejuvenating the wood with white oil, and finishing with a rough coat of shellac. To make sure the sliding doors would work well, I rubbed down the running strips thoroughly with oil and wire wool. I'm not sure what material these are made of, but it feels a bit like reinforced phenolic resin. The doors rest on the rails and are kept in place by a groove at the top which captures these wooden guides. In order to put the door back in, the guides need to be removed. Until the guides are reinstalled, the door is unstable, so I attached this clamp near the top to make sure things didn't fall out. The guides slot into the top and then need to be screwed into place. This was unbelievably fiddly to record, so I only bothered to capture fitting one of them to one of the three doors. The shelves can now go back in, though there are way fewer than I really need in a cabinet of this size, and even the supports for additional shelves are missing. The bottom two doors fit on runners in exactly the same way as the top one, but were even more fiddly as they're opaque and overlap with each other. To add insult to injury, they turned out to be the wrong way round, though in my defence I was putting them back the same way round they were when I found them. This bolt receiver actually needed to be behind the other door so it could be locked in place by a bolt from behind, so that door should be the one behind the other. The last thing to do was get some more shelves. I started by handing down the right supports for the side rails, but couldn't find an exact match. These sturdy supports were the closest match I could find, but didn't quite fit into the rail. To get them to fit, I used the bench grinder to adjust them. This works fine, but the metal is getting too warm to handle, so I'll need some water. I ground either side to clear the excess material on the lower flanges and make the tab just a tiny bit narrower. This made the supports fit great, so I just needed some more shelf timber. These shelf boards were exactly the right width, a decent price, and only a little bit too long. Cutting them to length with the mitre saw was fairly straightforward, but the boards were a little too long for the saw to travel and needed to be flipped around. I lined them up using the stationary blade in the slot, which worked well enough for tool shelves. The cabinet is no longer as straight and parallel as it once was, so the shelves had to be cut to slightly different lengths for a good fit, but now I have a whole load of shelves which are starting to fill up. The next workshop update will be about building a workbench for my machines. Thanks for watching, take care, I love you all.